In Unit 3, we're going to start looking at another president, our 27th president, a Republican named William Howard Taft. Taft, he graduated from Yale. He really preferred law to politics. Not too fond of politics at all, but he loved law. President McKinley sent him to the Philippines in 1900, where he improved their economy, he built schools and roads, and gave people some participation in government. He was Secretary of War when Roosevelt was president, and really Taft was handpicked by Teddy Roosevelt to lead this country in the progressive movement that he had set forth during his two terms as presidency. What's Taft noted for? Well, lots of people are noted for, you know, really kind of important things. Taft is noted for an embarrassing thing. At 325 pounds, sometimes he found himself stuck in the bathtub at the White House. How embarrassing must that have been? You know, when you call for a little help, what's wrong? Well, I'm stuck in the bathtub. And Taft actually had a larger bathtub installed so he could avoid entirely that embarrassment. And sometimes he got so heavy that he couldn't even tie his own shoes. He loved the game of golf. His nickname was Big Bill. And like I said, he really didn't like the presidency at all. His wife wanted him to be presidency. His dream that he wanted to do more than anything in life, his dream was to be on the Supreme Court. That's what he really wanted to do. But his wife kind of nudged him toward the presidency. Teddy Roosevelt said, hey, you would be a perfect progressive president, kind of nudged him toward the presidency. The presidency didn't fit him as well. The presidency fit Taft about as well as a pair of Speedos would have fit Taft while he was president. Henry Ford builds the first automotive assembly line while he was president. Women gained the right to vote in Western states. While he was president, the Mann Act was passed. M-A-N-N Act was passed. This prohibited transportation of women across state lines for immoral purposes. During his presidency, W.E.B. Du Bois founds the NAACP, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, a great organization that is going to spend decades overturning those Jim Crow laws or those segregation laws. During his presidency, Halley's Comet is observed. Robert E. Perry reaches the North Pole. During William Howard Taft's presidency, the manufacture of bakelite marks the beginning of the plastic age. And then, of course, plastics will be found in everything. During his presidency, the 16th Amendment, which created income tax, and the 17th Amendment, it's a direct election of senators. For the 17th Amendment, senators were picked by the state legislatures. And lots of state legislatures picked their friends or people who paid them money sometimes to pick them to be a senator. And at one time, the Senate was called the Millionaires Club because businesses would give them kickbacks to pass legislation that would protect their business and allow their businesses to grow. And so what the 17th Amendment did was allow we the people to elect. During his presidency, the first Father's Day is celebrated in Spokane, Washington. During William Howard Taft's presidency, the first successful parachute jump takes place. And I always wondered, was there an unsuccessful parachute jump? And if there was, what was going through this guy's mind when they tell him, you just jump out of this plane, this big sheet is going to open up, you're going to land safely. He's probably thinking, right. But anyway, the first successful parachute jump takes place during William Howard Taft's presidency. During William Howard Taft's presidency, 513 people are killed when the luxury liner Titanic goes down in the Atlantic. Jim Thorpe is at the Olympics and wins lots of gold medals, but later his medals are taken away because they said he played professional baseball. But Jim Thorpe, this great athlete, he's in the Olympics during William Howard Taft's presidency. During his presidency, a five-story Woolworth building opens in New York, and now the Progressive Party is formed. Taft was a great progressive president, even though Teddy Roosevelt didn't think so. He improved democracy, he improved social welfare, and he improved economic life for people in the United States. His administration initiated 80 antitrust suits. That was more than Teddy Roosevelt. During his presidency, a postal savings system was established. The Interstate Commerce Commission was directed to set railroad rates, trying to protect the consumer who are riding railroads. Now, he runs again. Now, he hated to campaign for president. He said it was one of the most uncomfortable 4 months of his life. 4 months. Today, a president really campaigns for about 2 years. Taft said it was the most uncomfortable 4 months of his life. He didn't want the presidency. During the election of 1812, he runs, this Republican. Now, if you remember, Teddy Roosevelt, he criticized Taft because he didn't think Taft was doing enough to push this progressive movement, and Teddy Roosevelt forms the Progressive Party, which is also known as the Bull Moose Party. And he runs against this guy named Debs, who was a socialist, ran under the Socialist Party. And so Deb runs against Taft, and the Democrats, they have this guy by the name of Woodrow Wilson. Well, the Republican Party was deeply divided. Some Republicans, man, they wanted Teddy Roosevelt to be president again. And some say, hey, Roosevelt, you had your chance, let Taft. And so they voted for Taft. Well, what this did is it split the Republican Party, and in comes our next president, who will be a Democrat, and we will look at the presidency of Woodrow Wilson.
Does anybody have a canned ham?